What happens 3 days after ovulation?
You start to wonder if you need to toss the old ovulation test pack and buy a pregnancy test pack instead.
Can't you get pregnant at 3 days after ovulation?
Ovulation plus or minus 1 day is when conception can occur. The day before is higher than the day after, because the egg lasts about a day in total.
Whereas sperm lasts several days.
That's why you can get pregnant having sex 3 days before your fertile day but not 3 days after. And it is why you can have sex 2 days after your fertile day through your period without getting pregnant.
That's the whole basis of natural family planning.
And losing track of which day is the fertile day is why women who use natural family planning get called mothers. If you did conceive, the sperm and egg have already combined and the new zygote is making its way down the fallopian tube.
What else is going on?
Ovulation is plus or minus a day on day 14, or the middle of your cycle.
Mine is around 4 weeks long.
The week before ovulation, the uterine lining was prepping to accept a newer ovule, whereas in a day or two, it will start to fade away if that egg doesn't implant.
I thought pregnancy tests didn't detect anything until day 24 or day 28.
3 days after ovulation is around day 17. And though the body starts responding to the embryo's chemical scream "I'm here, don't have a period" immediately, the chemical signals climb and become detectable in urine tests about a week later.
Only if you use one of the early pregnancy tests.
The early pregnancy tests cost more because they detect pregnancy hormones at half the level or so of the main pregnancy tests.
But we don't know if I am pregnant yet.
You're officially in the luteal cycle now for the ovary follicle, while the uterine lining is in the secretory phase.
That's the growing of blood vessels and tissue to prep for baby, so to speak, as the follicle withers and shrinks that release the egg.
It is really rare for someone to release two eggs during this phase, though it can happen.
Usually they release from two different ovaries if they are going to be released.
The ovary hormone levels except the luteinizing one are still climbing right now, but they'll start to drop around day 21.
And they'll bottom out around day 28.
They'll stay low through the menstrual cycle, day 1 through 6 or 7 depending on how long your period lasts.
That's still more than a week away.
Your body is just prepping for implantation if it occurs, though all the symptoms of ovulation due to those related hormones should be gone while nothing for PMS should kick in for at least a week.
I've heard implantation can cause cramps and spotting.
Nowhere near as bad as PMS, when they do occur. And it will happen several days before your period starts, but not yet.
So I'm just waiting.
Wait a week or two before you test. And give yourself 9 months and you'll have an even more definite answer.